Hey gang, Sam Ward here, and we are continuing devotional music, although maybe I'm cheating a little bit in that we're going to do a song that we are already singing here at the church, but I thought it might be good for us to reintroduce it and just think about it just a little bit. But I thought, why don't we just listen to it as we go, and we can break it down. This is from Cody, Carnes. It's called Firm Foundation, parentheses, He Won't. And it is a great song that speaks to the faithfulness of God. But I think it also gives us a chance to think a little bit about God in his transcendence and his imminence. Big words. We'll talk about that in just a minute. But let's jump in and listen to Cody, Carnes, He Won't. Here we go.
Christ is my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand, and everything around me is shaking. I've never been more glad that I put my faith in Jesus, 'cause he's never let me down. He's faithful through generations. So why would he fail now? He won't. He won't.
So there we go, right there. You can see that right away, Cody Carnes is building his song. See what I did there? He's building the song on the parable of the man who built his house upon the rock and not the sand. As you know, it comes from Matthew 7. Jesus is telling this parable, and he says, everyone who hears these words and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams came up, and the winds blew and beat against the house, yet it did not fall, because it had foundations on the rock. That's where the first line comes from. Christ is my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand. And this idea is all the way through the scriptures. Jesus actually quotes the Old Testament, and he's talking to the Pharisees when he says, have you never read in the scriptures, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone? Jesus is claiming that he is our cornerstone. What's interesting here at the beginning is that we are making statements about who God is, but we're really doing it from our own experience. Christ is my firm foundation. We're not just saying Christ is the firm foundation, but he is my firm foundation. And this gets a little bit to the transcendence and eminence, and that this is a big idea, right? God is faithful. We're going to get there in just a minute. He's faithful through generations. And then later, he's faithful in every season. Why would he fail now? That is the big transcendent truth. But the eminent part is that he is with me. He is my foundation. He is the rock on which I stand. When everything around is shaking, I've never been more glad. And so not only is there this big truth, but it's true for me. Some people might say this is a weakness of worship music and that it focuses a lot on my experience, the imminence of God. But the truth is, if you look through the Psalms all the way through Scripture, it has to be both. God is a firm foundation whether I believe it or not. But if I can't speak from my own experience and say God is my firm foundation, why would anyone else care, right? It needs to be yes and both. He is both transcendent and eminent. He is the firm foundation. He is my firm foundation. Let's keep going.
I've still got joy in chaos. I've got peace that makes no sense, so I won't be going under. I'm not held by my own strength, 'cause I've built my life on Jesus. He's never let me down. He's faithful in every season. So why would he fail now? He won't.
right there. We continue to sing, he won't, he won't, he won't. He's never let me down. Why would he fail now? He won't, he won't, he won't. Now, two things, going back to the transcendent and imminent. He won't fail because that's who his nature is. That's who God's character is. He is faithfulness incarnate. He is the most trustworthy being in the universe. You can trust him. He is faithful. That is true whether I believe it or not. But my experience also confirms that. He is faithful. But what does he mean by that? What does Cody mean when he sings, he's never let me down? He won't. He won't. He won't. Now, if he means that God answers every prayer and that life is going to be wonderful, unicorns, rainbows, and a Christian will never suffer or have any problems, that's not been my experience. It was interesting. I shared that this past weekend, and then someone in our ministry said they had someone in their family. I'm not going to share names because I don't have permission, but they had a traumatic experience. And it said, they started by saying, it really irritates me when I come to church and they sing the exact song that I need to hear on a really, really, really hard week. And this was an incredibly hard week for them. And they quoted this song. And they said, Christ is my firm foundation. And even though their life was not the way that they wanted, it had been very hard and difficult, they saw God's faithfulness in the midst of that. That's been my experience too. And I think that's the Apostle Paul's experience. Paul says that Jesus said to him, my grace is sufficient for you. My power is made perfect in weakness. And then in Romans, he says that we also glory in suffering because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance, character, and character, hope. So what does it mean when he's never let me down? Well, first of all, we're speaking to the character of God. He is a faithful God. He will never fail because that's who he is. He cannot deny himself. But also, it means that in my experience, when my life has fallen apart, when the world is shaking as we sing, I found that he is with me. He has not left me. He has not forsaken me. That he has answered my prayers, even if it's different than I want. It's not always yes. Sometimes it's no, but he's answered. He's always answered. And he's promised that I can put my faith in him, that he will save me. He will make me more like himself, and he will bring me home and be there the whole entire time, always present, always with me, to guide, to love, to heal. Maybe not the way I want, but he will. He will not fail. So the chorus goes on, and it speaks a little bit to that parable, the man who builds his house upon the rock, and you do this in advance. This is something that I'm doing right now in anticipation of the hard times that will come. This is true of our faith. It's also true of things like relationships. I found that when my life fell apart, it was the relationships that I already built into. Those people were some of the people who showed up. And so it's something that we do in anticipation of the hard times that will come.
Rain came and wind blew, but my house was built on you. I'm safe with you. I'm gonna make it through.
It's a simple song in a lot of ways. It's a simple song lyrically. It's even a simple song musically. What's interesting is the way they changed it up musically. There's some walk downs that make it interesting. And then, you know, one chorus, they start playing quarters instead of the typical 6/8 pattern. Lyrically, it's simple. In the midst of a world that might be falling apart right now, maybe your world, to remind ourselves that whether we believe it or not, God is faithful and he is a firm foundation. But also, it's in the midst of those storms, when it's not easy, that we can say with tears rolling down our face, I've never been more glad that I have Jesus, that I found him, I have faith in him, and that gives me a foundation when my life is falling apart. And that's the testimony that Christians can speak to, that speaks to the world in need. Christ is my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand.